Good morning. Welcome to worship with St. Peter's by the Sea in Huntington Beach. Whether you're watching online at the 10 o'clock hour or later in the day or even later in the week, we're really glad you're here. I'm Shirley Swaggerty, a worship elder at St. Peter's, and the vision of this church is to be a vibrant, flourishing, multi-generational, Christ-centered community, experiencing grace, practicing gratitude, and extending generosity so that we might glorify God in all things. So Pastor Steve and his wife Joy are on a well-deserved vacation. And that's really good news. We have more good news, but that was good news. And we also have the blessing of Reverend Candy Blankman from San Clemente Presbyterian Church. She will be sharing the message today from 1 Corinthians 12. I'd like to encourage you that during the service, feel free to put comments in the chat box. I know it feels strange because normally we're quiet in church, but this is a good way to stay connected and give each other a virtual hug. Another announcement I have is another opportunity, actually, that we have to stay in touch and to get to know each other a little better. And that's through the after service Zoom call that we do after church on Sundays, and we will be doing it today. It's called Refresh, Renew, and Relate. Or it might be Refresh, Relate, and Renew. But at any rate, if you need the information, it's at 11 o'clock, right after the service, and email Margot Backman. Hopefully her address will come on the screen right now, which is mbackman@stpetershb.org. And we usually spend about 30 minutes, and we just check in with each other and usually have a lighthearted question that we discuss. So I hope to see you a little bit later. And then I have one more announcement, and it's a reminder that we're taking a break during the month of August for our Wednesday conversations, and they'll start back up again in September. So let's continue now with the call to worship from Psalm 96. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord. Amen.
Skills and arts.
Let's make the words of that hymn that Mandy just sang our prayer today. Join me now. Father God, we thank you that you are here with us. You're here in our worship and in our hearts and in our homes. Your spirit is at work in each of us, in our lives, in our communities, and throughout the world. We love because you first loved us. We are your body and have your way, O Lord, as we yield to you. We praise you, we adore you, and we pray these things now in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Steadfast love, for as long as I live, and I will sing of your love, 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 for as long as I live, and I will sing of your love so wide that it welcomes the neighbor and will not divide. The trees so tall, of the ocean so deep, and your love for them all, and I will sing of your love, 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 for as long as I live. Your love is stronger than the mountains, soaks through me like the pouring rain. It's no wonder that I'm answering your call. Whenever someone needs a neighbor, and whenever there's a child in pain, we'll be working on a just world for all. Oh, I will sing of your love, 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 of your steadfast love, for as long as I live.
Good morning, St. Peter's by the Sea, brothers and sisters in Christ and dear friends. We've been together at different times in the last 10, 15 years, and I'm so thrilled that I've been invited to be with you again this morning. My only regret, of course, is that I can't be there physically with you. I hope that will happen in our future again soon. In the meantime, I hope you enjoy this message from Paul in his first letter to the Corinthians about the body of Christ, which not only applies to an individual congregation, but it applies to congregations across the geography, because corporately and universally, we are all part of Christ's body. And when one part of the body hurts, as you'll see in a picture I'm gonna show you this morning of a burn, the whole body feels it. And so I hope you'll be challenged by, inspired by, and motivated by this fairly commonly known passage from 1 Corinthians, but also I hope you'll be newly challenged to live it out in your place there in Huntington Beach and together across the Presbytery and across Southern California as the evidence of God's care for us as we care for each other. I can hardly wait to be with you again, but hope today will bless you and your congregation this morning. As I've said from the very beginning, my ministry card should say the not very Reverend Candy Blankman. Reverend is something my mother taught me. No one but the Lord should be revered, so I don't know who came up with that title, but it is what it is. I'm so grateful to be back on the big gray couch. It's just wonderful to have this opportunity to connect with so many of you that continue to join us for these worship evenings. I'm so grateful because no matter what we're thinking or feeling about the time we're in, it's very clear that God is using these times for purposes that are far beyond anything we could imagine. And it's really wonderful. It's really good to know that God can do even this. Our bodies, you know, are amazing things, and we're learning more and more about them through the years, through medical advances, and through even things like these viruses that are beginning to attack the body, and the doctors and scientists are learning so much about the human body. You know from the scripture, those of you who have been in it at all, that the body of Christ, Christians, followers of Jesus, are called the body of Christ. It's a metaphor used over and over in the scripture that you and me, all of us together, form a body, and it's Christ's body, and we each are part of that body. Tonight, I want us to think about that a little bit, but I want to show you a picture of a part of the body before we go there so you can see on the screen this hand. It's pretty horrible to look at, isn't it? This is a hand that obviously has been burned. And if anyone has ever burned any part of their body, even a little, you know it almost takes over. A little tiny burn on a fingertip can just drive you crazy for days. A small burn on your hand can do this. This was a burn, interestingly enough, you'd never guess what that burn came from. This was something I had never heard of, learned just this year, this spring, because that burn was caused by lime juice and the sun. Yes, lime juice and the sun. And actually, doctors call it margarita dermatitis. Yes, this is true. You can look it up. You can Google it. The technical name is phytophotodermatitis. But because it has happened to people who squeeze limes to make homemade margaritas with real fruit, and the juice soaks into their hands, and then they go out into the sun, and that's what happens. Burns all over their hands, blisters from photophytodermatitis or margarita dermatitis. My daughter's hands, that's a picture of her hands, her doctor had never heard of it, but she went to a dermatologist and they knew right away what it was. They'd heard of it before. So warnings to those of you who are making homemade margaritas in the summertime. I show you that picture. It was a very, very severe burn and very painful for weeks, but she's since healed and it's better. But I show you that because it immediately brings a kind of a visceral reaction, doesn't it? Doesn't it cause your whole body to just kind of go, oh my goodness. When I sent that picture to John earlier today for this evening's service, he texted back like, oh my goodness. He thought it was my hand. It wasn't, it was my daughter's hand. But it looks horrible and it makes your whole body react. That's why, one reason why, the scripture uses this analogy for followers of Christ being the body of Christ. Because what the scripture says is that we are so connected to each other by being together in Christ, by His Spirit, that when something happens to one part of the body, the whole body reacts. Just like when you see that picture of that burned hand, your whole body cringes. As the body of Christ, scripture says that we ought to be so connected to each other, so in tune with the Spirit, so caring for each other, that anything that happens to one part of the body happens to all the body. Let's look at it from Corinthians chapter 12 tonight. I'm going to read just a couple of portions
from the 12th chapter of 1 Corinthians, starting with verse 12, going to verse 18, and then we're going to skip down to 25 to 27. Paul says this: the human body has many parts, but the many parts make up one whole body. So it is with the body of Christ. Some of us are Jews, some are Gentiles, some are slaves, and some are free. But we all have been baptized into one body by one Spirit, and we all share that same Spirit. Yes, the body has many different parts, not just one part. If the foot says, "I'm not a part of the body because I'm not a hand," that does not make it any less a part of the body. And if the ear says, "I'm not a part of the body because I'm not an eye," would that make it any less a part of the body? If the whole body were an eye, how would you hear? Or if the whole body were an ear, how would you smell anything? But our bodies have many parts, and God has put each part just where He wants it. Skipping down to verse 25. This makes for harmony among the members, so that all members care for each other. If one part suffers, all the parts suffer with it. If one part is honored, all the parts are glad. All of you together are Christ's body, and each of you is a part of it. This is a beautiful picture in the scripture of what it means to be followers of Jesus Christ, working and living and loving and struggling and crying and laughing together. It really is important that we think about this, and I think the image of my daughter's hand really helps because it's that visceral reaction. And what Paul is teaching here is that in the body of Christ, there ought to be a visceral reaction when other members of the body are troubled. When other members of the body are rejoicing on both ends of the spectrum, it's really important that we realize this and think about this. We exercise our different gifts, and not one of us is exactly the same. And it takes a whole village of people, God's people, to be able to be God's church, His body together. I can't even imagine what it takes to make a service like this work. We're so grateful for the talented people who are giving their time and energy to make this possible during this time. And we'll continue using these gifts and abilities for a long time down the future. But I could never do that. I could never, ever, no matter how much I tried, could I be that technically aware and savvy and educated and able to apply it. It just isn't in my DNA. It's not who I am. And so the body of Christ is like that. One does this, another does this, another has this ability. And if you notice, the scripture says, God puts each one where He purposes to have it be. Each of us are there and where we are for a reason, to make the body work well, function well together. I'm an image person, and so this idea of the whole body being an eye is pretty gross if you think about it. Like, if that's all there was no other part to the body but just a big eye or lots of eyes all together. But it is the diversity of the body that makes it beautiful, that makes it interesting, and that allows it to do all these different things. So it's really important as we continue to discover and explore what it means to be a church, what it means to be God's body in Christ's body at this time. It's coming in a variety of ways. Beginning this week, we have people offering their backyards for We Church gatherings, smaller, safe gatherings of people worshiping together. On this campus, we'll have rooms with smaller numbers of people gathering together. And it takes gifted people to make that happen physically. It takes gifted people to make it happen spiritually. And it takes willing and able people that God has put in just the place He wants them for such a time as this. It's really very exciting to see it coming to be. With all of the challenges of the time we're in, I have to tell you, I'm excited about what I see God doing in and through this time. Each of you who are listening tonight, each of you who are watching this living room, need to understand that you have a place, as the scripture says, where God wants you. You have a place in the body of Christ where God wants you exactly to fit in and to contribute and to be what no one else can be. It's really important that we all do the part that God has called us to do. What I love about the church, the body of Christ, is that It's not like you get a memo from heaven or an email or a text that says, here's the part I want you to play. It really takes the body together helping us figure that out. If you are a person that played sports at all, some of you learned whether you were right-handed or left-handed by playing a sport because you knew which hand was dominant. Some of you have learned that you are very capable, I don't know where John Ezekiel went, but that you have a lot of agility in your fingers because you've learned that you can play the piano like nobody else can. Everyone is given gifts, the scripture says, and put right where God wants them in the body so that the whole body working together does what God has purposed it to do. One of the most important functions of the body of Christ is caring for each other. That was in this text as well. It says, so that all of the members care for each other, it makes for harmony among the members. Caring for each other means we know each other. We know about each other. We know what's going on in each other's lives. And it's really important. Just this week, I had a wonderful experience of being included in the celebration of someone's birthday. It was on Sunday, and her husband texted a bunch of people and said, it's my wife's birthday today. Would you drive by and honk and wave and wish her a happy birthday to help her celebrate this day? I can't tell you how many people I know of that hopped in their cars on a minute's notice and went and did just that thing. What an excellent way to show love and care. And if we weren't connected, we wouldn't know and be able to do that. But the body of Christ, the hand, the foot, the eyes, the ears, all playing together make for Christ's body functioning in a way that we can celebrate such a thing together. Even under times when celebrations are hard, and many of you I know have been involved in parades and fun ways of doing parties during this time, but it was such a wonderful thing that one part of the body acknowledged another part of the body, needed other parts of the body to come around in order to be the body of Christ together for celebration. But friends, we also need to do that for suffering. We also need to do that when things are difficult and when things are hard. We need to come alongside each other. And as Romans 12, 15 says so clearly, we're to be happy with those who are happy, and we are to weep with those who weep. This is what it means to be the body of Christ. It means all the parts working together to bring alongside whatever is needed. And so when people are celebrating, we celebrate with them. But when people are weeping, we weep with them. You notice the scripture verse in Romans doesn't say, come alongside and fix it and make it better. It says, come alongside and suffer, weep with, empathize with, listen and hear and cry with people. That's what the body of Christ is designed to do. But if we don't trust each other, if we aren't in groups enough to let each other know what's going on, we will never know, and people will suffer alone. They will suffer quietly, and they will suffer without the encouragement of the other parts of the body. It's really important that each one of us figure out some way, sometimes with the help of other people, sometimes with trial and error, what part does God want you to play in the body of Christ? But I can tell you this for sure. He wants all of us to weep with people who weep, and to rejoice with people who rejoice, to be happy with people who are celebrating, and to come alongside and weep with those who weep. We are here as Christ's body for each other. Especially in times like this, we need to be here for each other. And I am so grateful to be part of one body, one faith, one baptism, one Lord Jesus Christ over all. And together, we can function healthy, more robustly, more boldly, more effectively together. Let's pray. Lord God, it is so amazing how much a picture is worth a thousand words. In this picture of a burned hand, I pray, as strange as it may seem, will be a reminder to your people that every part of the body matters. Every person in the body of Christ matters. And when one part of the body is burned, The rest of the body needs to come around and suffer together with that person. And when one part of the body celebrates, when it's a high five, when it's a great event, that we would come alongside each other like a birthday parade and tell each other by taking the time to drive by and honk our horns that we love each other because we are the same body together. Lord, would you help us in these days when we are getting tired, we're getting discouraged, many of us are just struggling with depression, with so much isolation and so many things different than they usually are. Would you help us to remember that we are one body? Would you help us by your Spirit to understand what our part to play is in that body? And would you help us together function like the body of Christ in such a way that the world watches and says, wow, look at how they love each other. And the world watches and says, I want to be a part of that kind of body. Oh Lord, might what you describe in the scriptures be true of us here. In Jesus' name we pray, who is able to do all this and more. Amen.
I know they're empty, but with you I can be used for beauty in your perfect plan. All I am is yours. Take these feet. I know they stumble, but you use the weak. You use the humble, so please use me. All I am. A living sacrifice, no longer my own. All I am is yours. All I am is yours. Oh, take this heart, set it on fire, shining.
And now, brothers and sisters in Christ, may the power and presence of Christ, which is able to do far more than we could ever imagine or ask or think, may that power and presence be at work in you as you do your part that God has placed you in the body, so that the work of Christ can be done fully and completely at work, in the home, at school, wherever Christ takes you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. And may the peace of Christ be with you.
Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love, the fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above. Before our Father's throne, we pour each other flows the same.